Welcome to this tutorial on ribbon microphones. Before quality condenser microphones, also known as capacitor microphones, became widely available in the 1950s, ribbon microphones were the first choice for professional recording engineers. Despite their technical disadvantages, they are still used today, especially for recordings taking place in acoustically controlled spaces where a smooth mid-range response is required. In the past, Nat King Cole, Ella Fitzgerald, Elvis Presley and Billie Holiday all made classic recordings with ribbon mics. Unlike other microphones, ribbon microphones are simple in design. A thin foil of metal is suspended within the field of two magnets. This arrangement is often known as the ribbon motor. When a sound wave hits the foil, it moves and causes an electrical signal to be induced in the foil itself. This signal is sent to be boosted by a transformer within the body of the mic and then down a mic lead to a microphone preamplifier. Until powerful miniature magnets became available, ribbon microphones were large, expensive to manufacture, and produced a very low output. Today, they can be much smaller, produce louder signals, and it is even possible to make your own. Almost all ribbon microphones have a figure of eight polar pattern and pick up sound equally from the front and rear. This means they pick up a great deal of ambient room sound and are therefore mostly used in acoustically controlled spaces. The sound they produce is relatively uncoloured compared to other microphones, and they are therefore often used as overheads when recording orchestra sections and drums. Ribbon microphones exhibit a pronounced bass lift proximity effect, boosting low frequencies when close to a source, and are therefore usually placed a meter or more away from the source. However, this effect can be used to help thicken thin sounds and can therefore be effective for some singers and other performers. When placed at a distance beyond the proximity effect, ribbon microphones have a flat frequency response up to 15 kHz, above which their sensitivity drops dramatically. At first listen, this characteristic can make them sound dull, but they can be useful for taming excessively trebly sources or recording instruments without high frequency detail, such as electric guitar cabinets and brass instruments. This lack of high frequency response also helps to emphasize the smooth mid-range response they are both capable of and loved for. Most ribbon microphones not only do not require phantom power, but can be seriously damaged by it. Therefore, extreme care must be taken when using them with a microphone preamplifier. Models that require phantom power will probably be fitted with modern active circuitry designed to mitigate some of their shortcomings, such as low output, limited frequency response, and the proximity effect. However, purists maintain that these shortcomings help give ribbon microphones their character, and additional electronics detract from the experience of using one. Early ribbon microphones produced a very low output and therefore required specialist preamplifiers to boost their outputs to usable levels. Today, most models produce sufficient output, albeit lower than most condenser microphones. Some micpres have a special ribbon mode that disables phantom power and enables circuitry optimized to receive the mic's lower than normal output. Because of this low output, signal-to-noise ratio is compromised, and ribbon microphones are not always the best choice for quiet sources. The foil at the heart of the ribbon motor is delicate in some models and can be easily damaged. Although some motors can handle high sound levels up to 160 decibels, sudden shocks, plosives, and extreme transients can tear the foil. Also, because the foil is suspended, it can sag if the microphone is not stored upright. For this reason, many models come with an extended motor replacement guarantee. The script for this tutorial, along with accompanying images, can be found at our website, projectstudiohandbook.com. We suggest you subscribe at our YouTube channel and join our mailing list at our website to receive notification of new videos, blog posts, and subscriber-only extras. Thanks for watching.